Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I will be covering rib command in this video. You can search rib command by going to more, go to rib. So there are multiple other methods to see where this rib command is located. Another method is you can find a command actually. In fact, any command in Siemens-NX, you can just write it down, RIP, and then enter it. And then it will find for you. It will take a time, it depends on your system, but it will show you where this rib command is located. However, the original location is insert, design feature, and rib. But you can find it from here. Go to menu, insert, and then design feature. Yeah, and then you will be able to find rib command. We will move forward. So before we move forward, I will let you know what is rib actually and why it is important. This is a normal geometry where you put like fasteners or screws or anything here. And you might have seen this kind of geometry in many plastic parts, especially in toys. So these yellowish colors walls are basically ribs, which gives strength to this beam. Another example is this another plastic part, but yeah, this kind of structures called ribs. So I will show you, I will cover everything in the rib commands. Yeah, there's another example as well. This one I created to hang my gloves actually, and then 3D printed it. So let's go straight to rib command. So you can go ahead and click on the rib command and it will pop up all the sub commands, I would say. And if you want to be able to see all the subs command, you can unhide it, I would say. Yeah, go to rib less and you will be able to hide all those like non-wanted or commands. And you can go to more and then you will be able to find all the commands. So this is preview. So if you disable preview, you won't be able to see the real time changes. And the target is obviously our main body, which we want to create a rib on. And then you might need to define a section curve. So I already prepared the two example curves as well. Let me explain about these two sketches real quick. I created this datum first. You can see here on the corner on the circular cylinder. And then I created a tiny, what it says, sorry. I'm gonna just click it. And if you are watching this video, you should be able to create datum and as well as the sketch. Okay, another sketch is just a simple sketch. It's just a horizontal line, that's it. It doesn't matter where you sketch, it can be perpendicular, it can be on the horizontal plane, it really doesn't matter. It just need a single geometry, like single or multiple geometry, that's all it matter. And you will be able to find out why. So I will select rib command and select this tiny geometry, which is sketch. And now we can see how it created a tiny rib. There are multiple options in walls, perpendicular to section and parallel to section. I will cover parallel to section plane in another geometry. And then you can find out there are two options, symmetric and asymmetric. We will go with symmetric and then put 5. You can see how it changes the thickness. Another way is you can drag this blue arrow and adjust the thickness according to your application. And I'm gonna go with 1.5, and that's more than enough for me. If I click on the asymmetry, how it changes, you can see it. It will distribute 1.5 on the one side. And you can change the direction by double clicking on this blue arrow. So it's simple. Another option is offset. So offset is really good command. Let's say I have created this sketch a little bit lower than this surface, I mean the top surface. And if I want to move my top face of rib higher than this sketch, I will select this tiny blue arrow and drag it to top. And now you can see how it is going upward, and I can select until it touches main face. I can do it by going downward as well for negative offset, and I can put any numbers like 3 or 5 or 6, and you can see how it changes. Or maybe I will change the direction and put 2, and then it will changes accordingly. We will move forward to the draft command, which is from cap, and then you put any angle, let's say 5. You can see here how it automatically changes angle, right? I would say last option in this is combine rib with target. If I want select this and just click OK, it won't combine with the parent geometry. Then I will go back to edit parameters and I will click on the combine rib with target. And now you can see that both have a same color, which means that this rib is combined with the parent geometry. Okay, so another option is cap command. And in cap command, there are two methods. And the second one I will cover with this rib. So let's say go with the first option and just select the rib. And you can see how it created the horizontal. But what if you want to match this horizontal line according to outer lips, which are circular? You can see here, right? And if I want to create the same geometry, I have to select this plane somewhat, and I would go with the from selected and select just this face, this lip face of parent geometry. It will automatically create the same geometry as the lips are, or at the sides are, right? You can however use all these options like offset command. I will just put 0 here, and then you can also use the draft command as well, and you can see how it changes accordingly, right? Angle 5 or maybe 10, maybe 1, right? And I will go with combined ribs because that's a critical part. Okay. So moving forward, we will go to another geometry. So I can explain you the last option. So let's go to rib command and just click on the sketch, and it will automatically highlight the last selected option. So I would go with the perpendicular selection, and you can see how it automatically created the basic geometry, I would say. But we don't want that. We want to parallel to the bottom face. So we will select the parallel to section plane, and that's it. Like, I'm not sure why you won't be able to use the other option. Maybe this geometry is not compatible for other option. Just don't worry about it. If you really want to put drafts on here, you can always click on the draft command and you can do it manually. Okay guys, so I hope you like this video, and if you want more videos, please comment on this video and subscribe my channel, and I will keep updating you guys with more and more Siemens-NX tutorials.